Doug, so good afternoon, and here we are with Miss Catherine Fu, who is the Assistant Regional Director of Sales for Millennium Copthorne International, based in the Singapore office. Now, Miss Fu, in Singapore there's a lot of exciting new projects coming up very, very soon. We have Resorts World there, Sentosa, there's Marina Bay by the Sands. But within the hotel industry, there's one in particular that has caught my attention, and that is Studio M. Which is basically a new project from Millennium. Could you tell us a little bit more about this new brand and the hotel itself, please?
Right. This hotel is actually newly built, brand new. 365 rooms, and the hotel is all duplex. This project will be open in March 26 this year. And entire inventory is 365 rooms. Room size is about 22 square meters, and it's a loft. That means you expect a duplex, upstairs and downstairs. Yeah.
This is very unique in Singapore. This is a loft, so you have a duplex for every single one of the rooms?
Yes, indeed. 365 rooms is going to be a duplex.
Excellent. So does this mean that the rooms are basically a little bit narrower than your traditional hotel
room?
Yes,
indeed. Yes. It's a lifestyle hotel. Yeah.
What does that mean, a lifestyle hotel? What is a lifestyle hotel?
Lifestyle hotels normally, I would say, we have a lot of internet, we have Wi-Fi, we have a lot of internet gadgets into the hotels. So we are targeting the young market between 20, 30 and 40.
Oh, I'm glad I just fit into that category. I was lucky. Yeah, I was worried where you were going with that for a moment. So every room is a duplex, very high tech.
Yes.
With it having a duplex, where are the beds? Are the beds on the upper level, the lower level?
Okay, it's very unique. We have two types of room capability. Some of the beds is below and some of the beds is upstairs. So we have two duplex. Yes, depending on the guest preference.
Oh, I see. And within the room, you have staircase within the room to go to the upper
floor?
Yes,
indeed we do. Below can be a bedroom and upstairs could be a study rooms. Yes.
And have you used an open mezzanine concept where people on the upper floor can look down into the lower floor? Or is it closed off?
The upstairs will be able to view the lower floor. You can see. And if you are downstairs, you have to walk one step up and then you can see the upstairs as
well. Oh, very interesting. Yeah. And how do you know how high the ceiling is then in the mezzanine areas?
It's 3.8 meters.
3.8 meters in total. And with you having two floors, does that mean you also have to have two television sets?
No. You only have one television set which is facing the bay.
Right.
Yeah. And for the study rooms area, we do not have any TVs.
Do you think that's not going to be a problem? Because wouldn't people prefer to sit downstairs and watch TV rather than sit on their bed upstairs and watch TV? Won't that be an issue?
No issues, actually, because these are the new trends that people is looking upon.
Okay, and for the television channels, will you have English Premier League football? Will you have major sporting events?
Yes, we do. Most of the premium events and the TV, we do have.
Right. Now, with this property, I remember a couple of years ago, the ITB Asia, when it was first announced, the idea, the concept, you mentioned, not you personally, but the company mentioned that you would be pushing the technology envelope. How far have you pushed the envelope? Will you have things like self-service check-in? Is there any unusual items in terms of technology use?
Okay, for check-in, we will have a check-in counter, and the check-in counter is very unique because it's an island for your check-in, and we have 6 tons of chandelier that goes down to the island. There will not be any sitting area, and we'll be using iMac laptop check against it, so the whole thing is white. Yes, it's very clean, and the rooms, in terms of color scheme, we use white.
Oh dear me.
Yes.
Now, I have seen a white room, a Philips dark room in Hong Kong. Beautiful, beautiful. It looks amazing, especially when it's brand new. But tell me, what is the secret of a hotel? How do you maintain a white colour scheme that you have when it's new and looks perfect? How will that view be able to maintain that in 1 year, 2 years or 3 years' time? Because obviously there is wear and tear, isn't there? And it's not just a question of cleaning. How do you manage to maintain the sparkling whiteness that you'll have at the beginning?
Job.
So you don't have any magic products?
No.
It's just hard work.
Yes.
With this hotel, obviously sometimes you have hotels that like to call themselves boutique, they like to call themselves trendy and funky and hip. simply because they can charge more. Now, with your property, it does sound amazing. It's something that I think a lot of travellers would like. They'd like a section downstairs which becomes similar to a suite. But the big question is, how much are you going to charge for this?
Okay, it's relatively very reasonable rate. We're doing an opening of $185.
Singapore?
Singapore dollars.
Net?
Plus. And this is with Wi-Fi and a breakfast.
That is your opening promotion?
Yes. And these promotions will from March till September. It will end September. Yeah.
Okay, so with inclusive of tax and service, that becomes what? Around 200 and...
Yes.
210.
Times 1.17%.
Right.
$1, yes.
Right. Have you never, as a company, have you not thought to, and it is a lifestyle hotel, and as it is your new brand,
yes,
have you not considered going with net rates rather than plus plus, inclusive of tax and service charge? You know, the low-cost airfares, they started offering $1 fares where nobody could really fly.
Because the tax percent, the 10% service charge will go back to the service staff, and the government tax will go back to the government. Unless travel agents,
I see, so it's really from the travel agent's perspective, because
yes,
you could say it's $200 net, and then who you're giving the tax and service to, that doesn't affect the consumer.
Normally you do a plus-plus rate.
Plus-plus
yes,
at the moment.
Yes, you do a plus-plus rate. Even though travel agents will still try to do a plus-plus rate.
Right. Now, the hotel is located in an interesting area of Singapore. It's located right next to the Gallery Hotel,
yes,
I believe,
yes,
in Robertson Quay. Can you tell us a little bit about the area the hotel is in?
The area is a happening area in Singapore. There's a lot of joints, a lot of pubs, a lot of wine bar, and in fact, there's a lot of foreigners who love to go pubbing there during weekends, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Yeah, it's a lovely area to go.
So you have a lot of food and beverage outlets all around you?
Yes, indeed. Fusion food, Japanese food, everything, you can get it from there. And there's a lot of wine bar, and the wine is relatively inexpensive, probably $20 to $30. You can get very good wine.
Excellent. That sounds like a great place to stay.
It is. I love that place.
And in terms of the F&B, will you as a hotel, will you have your own F&B outlet?
Okay, that's a very good question. We don't have any F&B that is managed by the hotel. Yes. So what we did is we have sublet to tenants, to the hotels, and they will manage the restaurant. Yeah, because we do not want to compete with the Robertson Quay, because there's too many F&B outlets. It's amazing.
So your customers, how will if they fancy a burger in their room? Have you come up with a solution for that? Can they ring up the restaurants close by for delivery?
Yes.
Or
we will have a restaurant function. We will serve breakfast there, so we will work with the restaurant people to provide breakfast for our guests.
Excellent. So we have free Wi-Fi. Is there LAN in the rooms as well? The internet, is it cable?
Yes,
as well?
Wi-Fi.
You have Wi-Fi,
yes,
and cable,
yes,
as well. Do you have any other facilities at the hotel?
We have a swimming pool. All right. The swimming pool is actually 25 meter length.
Right.
And we have a gym. Yeah. And we have a beer garden whereby we brew our own beer. Yeah.
Oh, I see. So you don't do food, but you do next best thing, beer.
No, because this is not black as well. So these are the things that we have to do.
Excellent. I see. So you have a brewery within the hotel.
Yes.
They brew their own beer,
yes,
on site.
Yes, outside the terrace.
Oh, and they brew it at your hotel.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes,
dear me. And will that be part of the opening on March the 26th? Did you say?
No, the hotel will open on March 26th, but F&B outlet will be slightly later, probably a month or two.
Okay. All right, so in a couple of months, then people will be able to go to the swimming pool. And is it on the same level, this
yes,
microbrewery,
yes,
you have?
Yes, it is. It's a very nice contemporary outlet. There's a beer garden, there's a fusion food. The gym is very near to the restaurant, and also the pool itself.
Right. Okay, so from a guest staying there, who is it you're trying to target in the initial phase?
Okay, FIT travelers, frequent individuals travelers. Probably business and long term, for 7 days, 6 days, yes. Because in the room, we'll be able to provide microwave for long stay, whereby they can cook their own food.
Oh, excellent. So you have microwave, and upstairs with a bedroom. There's how many bathrooms is there?
There's one shower, study shower, and there's one bathroom, which is a WC, so there's two toilets.
Okay, March 26th is the soft opening. And how many rooms will open in the first day?
100 rooms.
100 rooms. All right, well, thank you very much for your time today, and I wish Studio M the best of luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Looking forward to seeing you in Singapore.
I look forward to it.
Thank you.